Welcome back to PGA Chain Design Channel. Today we are going to talk about this stacking ring and how they can be arranged nicely on the bottom but flowy on the top. Are you ready? Let's get started. We are going to start the ring at the front view and decide what ring size we are doing. So 16 is fine, like what I do usually. And then we want to draw a line from the center, snapping into this quadrant. And depends on how big you want it, depends on your design. So I'm going to have roughly about 6 millimeter width when they all stacking together. So I wanted to have 3 on each side, and then that give me something like this. Okay, I'm gonna mirror that piece that we just draw and send it to the other side by mirror, and then so I will have something like that. Okay, first of all, I'm going to draw my first and last ring, and I'm going to use the curve. It's called interpolate point. And I'm going to start with something like this. You can be creative, but make sure that the it doesn't have like really tight area. You may have a problem when you try to sweep and it may not look nice. So we want to have the curve is more like a gentle curve there. And you keep editing until you find something that you like. The second curve, again, gonna snapping into that point, and we can have it come over something like this. And then if that's not the things that you want, you can edit it one more time. All right, so I need to have 5 in between. So I'm going to use, this is a total 7 rings stacking together. So I'm gonna come to the top view and use the commands called twin curve. I'm going to twin U and U in between. So it will even it out to twin the curve like this to create those profile there. So now I have all those curve. I need this curve in this orientation. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna split this curve first in half. So I'm going to split by this curve. So I have the top curve. I'm going to put into the red colors easier for you to see. We're also creating a new layer, and that's the layer we want to work on it. So the first we're gonna use the curve from two view, and we're gonna do this one with the first curve. Again, this one with the second curve, and then you're gonna do that to all of them. Make sure that you color it right so you won't get confused on what is what. And you cannot do all of them at once, you have to do it separately. So that's how we get the top one. For the bottom one, I'm just gonna copy the rest of them in there. And that's how you get the bottom one. If you like it, let's go ahead to select both of the top and the bottom, and let's go ahead to join them. So now they become one curve. So now we need to do the profile on the bottom. I would like to have it on the bottom is because it's just much easier if you need to do editing and then your seam is on the bottom. So let's use the conic corners on rectangle, and I want to type it 1 and 1. So then I will have something like this. That will be the profile for us to sweep, and I want to move that to the endpoint right here. And then just basically copy a lot of them, because the distance that I have is exactly 1. So this will be fine. If you want to have a different size and thickness, you might want to calculate before the gap on the top as well. Let's try 1 and see what happens. Sweep 1, rail 1, cross section, and then we get something like this. And I just gonna keep doing for the rest of it. Oops. This is a good example right here. If you happen to have something like that, something wrong with your curve, the best way to solve the issue is actually rebuild all this point. So let's go ahead to rebuild all the curve. And we do not want to have too much of a change here, but 15 seems okay. I'm just going to edit one more for 16. So if you see the change is too big that you don't like it, you can actually bump up to more point and they will get more closer. So let me bump it up to 24. So you get really close to set this area, and that is a settable, and I'm going to click OK. We also need to double make sure it is still round enough. If not, we have to create a surface and pull it back. So let's try one more time and see if that still the problem is still there. So let's go ahead, sweep one. Got this one as a rail cross section, and it's much better now. So I'm just gonna go ahead to finish the rest of it. And you can arrange some stone setting on the top if you want to. A course for stone setting is in the description below and teach you all different type of stone setting. I want to give a big thanks for Dari Jewelry, Carlos Hernandez, Conquers Jewelers, Slavisa Panovic. If I pronounce your name wrong, I'm really sorry. But I want to thank you for your donation. That really helped me to improve my channel, buying the equipment that I need and update the software. Thank you for your donation. And thanks everybody for your watching. I'll see you next.